We're about to have a talk.
No, be this girl.
Okay, so this is a video that I never wanted to make. But try to learn how to cope with my depression and anxiety. I'm gonna start off saying that I was one of the, you know, people that thought anxiety and depression was all just bullshit. I thought it was stupid. You know, I didn't believe anyone. I guess it was because I was so happy, and I never thought. I never knew what being sad. But, I have depression, I have anxiety, it hit me like a ton of bricks. I went from being this outgoing person that always had a smile on his face, always made sure everyone was perfect before I was. I just never let anything affect me. I was a strong person, and then out of nowhere, just, I didn't know what to think about it, you know. At first I thought it was just like, oh, it'll go away during the day. After the day hit, it was still there. I was like, oh, I'll probably gone in a couple days later, still there. Whew, I might be pushing it, but let's try a month. Month went and it was still there, and it happened, and I still feel it to this day, and it's been 6 months. I started hating everyone. I started hating myself. I didn't want to look at myself in the mirror because I didn't know who I became. I felt lost. I would look at my family, my girlfriend, my friends, and I wouldn't know who they were anymore. This is something that is not a joke, and you should take seriously. I'm not gonna say any names, but I lost someone very close to me to suicide. Lots of people, actually, and at first I thought it was something very selfish, and just tell myself, why would they do it? But going through it, it just, you don't feel anything. All you do is, I always thought people that, you know, harmed themselves or killed themselves were just being stupid, which, all reality, it is. It's selfish. But living with depression and anxiety, you don't feel like yourself. You don't feel real. And that's why people do it. Because pain is the only thing that makes them feel real. Personally, I've never done anything to harm myself. I'm not gonna lie, I've had a lot of thoughts though. Don't have them anymore, thank God. But I'm not gonna lie, it was to the point where I was fixing to give up everything. I was fixing to leave everyone behind, because I couldn't handle it anymore. But I can't say it's gonna get better, but I'm gonna let you know the easiest way to deal with it is you have to try to forget about it. You have to try to move on every day. You have to try to just act like it's not there. Whenever you have a bad thought, you tell yourself. I know it might sound weird. Oh, I'm having a conversation with myself. No. You have to tell yourself, stop. What are you doing? You're better than this. And then move on. And that's what I've been doing. I'm not going to say that I feel 100%, but I feel a lot better than what I used to. Honestly, if I didn't get help, I probably wouldn't be here today. That's the honest truth. I never had any attempts at suicide or self-harm, but, you know, who knows, a couple weeks without getting help, who knows what could have happened. But anyone ever needs anyone to talk to, this is probably, a lot of kids in my school are going to see this. If anyone has, you know, feelings like that, you know, if they need someone to talk to, you know, I would happily talk to them and be that person to show them that they're not alone. Even if I don't know you personally, you know, comment down below. We can exchange information. We can talk if you want to. But there's always going to be someone that understands your situation. I didn't believe that at first until, you know, I actually talk to people that's been going through the same stuff that I'm going through, and it's been very helpful. And I just want to say, if you're going through it, you're not alone. Thank you for watching. You guys have an awesome day. Bye. Or night.